Joshua did what he do. You know, Joshua the king, he didn't start to understand things. He like computes these type of things. He said, okay, he moving to the left too much. Oh, he moving to the right too much. Oh, I gotta go through the middle to get the up. You dig what I'm saying? That's what Joshua do. I can't even figure out how Joshua do what he do. What I'm gonna tell you is this. Fucking with the best, man. These other channels can't do this. Like, I'm giving it to you, man. Subscribe to the channel. Yeah, I know. AJ said line them up, right? He said he'd take on all comers. You see me? Let me do this video. I'm going to get back to you, player. Listen, I think Andy Ruiz is a better fight than Big Baby Miller for my boy Anthony Joshua. The truth, man. Look, people, I need y'all to understand something, man. Yes, this fight is at last moment, last minute. You know, Ruiz got so many weeks to train. But Ruiz, man, this guy is front foot dominant, right? And he throw many punches in different variations, and he's able to slip and move. Most importantly, he can counter punch on the front toe. That means when Anthony Joshua would throw that straight down the pipe, right, or that hook that he loves to throw, or the uppercut, Ruiz is able to slip side to side and counter punch at the same time. That's something that Gerald Miller couldn't do. See, Gerald Miller was going to be a good test for Joshua, in my opinion, because he's a big man. He was going to come forward, use all that energy, and throw punches and bunches and bunches. And Joshua, I wanted him to feel that pressure. I wanted him to, you know, use that defense and counter punch and get up out of that situation and show us great strength and ability against a young, hungry lion, PED user, like Gerald Miller. But we got a guy that's totally different from Gerald Miller, man. Yeah, Ruiz is front foot dominant, but he lets his punches go with education. You see what I'm saying? He just not going to be throwing a four-punch combination. He going to throw a 1-2 slip. You dig what I'm saying? A 3-4 slip to the right or the left. But he got great footwork, and he could bang to the body. He's a shorter man, right? So AJ, for me, I think he does well against guys that are his size. You see what Povetkin was able to give Joshua issues for the first three rounds, right? Because he was the shorter man, and he was faster. Well, faster-footed than Joshua was for the first three rounds, until Joshua caught up with him. You know, Joshua did what he do. You know, Joshua the king, he didn't start to understand things. He like computes these type of things. He said, okay, he moving to the left too much. Oh, he moving to the right too much. Oh, I gotta go through the middle to get the up. You dig what I'm saying? That's what Joshua do. I can't even figure out how Joshua do what he do. What I'm gonna tell you is this. Joshua dealing with a guy in Ruiz that's a bigger man. He's bigger than Povetkin. He got faster hands than Povetkin. I don't know if he got faster feet than Povetkin, but I will tell you this. His feet is fast enough to slip those shots. So if Ruiz is faster than Joshua as far as hand speed go, he's definitely faster than Joshua as far as foot speed go. He's going to be able to create certain, you know, angles where he can come in and get out. Come in and get out. Go to the body, go up top and get out. And I told you guys, he's educated in the way he throws punches. Joshua, on the other hand, is the truth. He's going to have to go, you know, come into this fight and think outside the box. See, the American fans is going to be in for a treat. Because whatever Joshua decides to, how he decides to attack Ruiz's abilities to shut him down, it's going to be very interesting, man, you know. The long jab is one, but the long jab got to be double and triple. The two got to come. The body shot is going to work early on because that chops the tree down. That slows him down. I would love to see Joshua on the front foot push Ruiz back. Use your angle. Don't get too close because he's a beautiful, beautiful, I mean beautiful, counterpuncher Ruiz is. So Joshua's going to have to keep his distance. He's going to have to use that long jab. He's got to go to the body. He's going to have to create space so he can land great, clean punches. So, you know, when it comes down to skill for skill, we already know Joshua got him. But Ruiz is better in certain departments, foot speed and hand speed. So this is going to be a great fight. I like this matchup. A lot of guys are shitting on this fight. But y'all understand that Ruiz, it was your boy Ortiz, he ducking. He don't want that $7 million with a retard, right? We know your boy Scotty Weller said he don't want to fight my boy AJ. Well, Shelly Finkel said Joshua, well, Deontay Sloppy Wilder is busy. He got a lot on his plate for 2021. So no one wants to fight Joshua. So this is the best fight for Joshua right now. You see what I'm saying? You know, the so-called tough guys don't want to fight. What can we do? We got to get in the ring with somebody. We got to get in the ring with the up-and-coming fighters, man. You know, I would say this to you. You know, if you calling this a bum bash, well, you know it ain't Joshua's fault. He wanted the best. He even gave these guys big money to get in the ring. You see me? So it ain't that. But I understand some of it because a lot of you guys don't know Luis, and y'all look at him, he's a, you know, chubby big dude, you know, he got scales, he's funny, y'all know he's front foot dominant, y'all know he's a warrior, but if you seen the fight between him and Parker, for me that was the worst Andy I ever seen. You know, I've been following this dude's career because I like to see the heavyweights that's going to be in the ring ultimately with Joshua down the line, and unfortunately he's going to get his ass whooped sooner than I thought. But against Parker, he looked as slow, like he ain't pressed the fight like he normally do. Like, I think he was going for the belt, and I felt that he just was like, you know what? I got to be perfect. You see me? I got to do this thing and be, you know, too scientific. You know, I got to go in this fight and just be a boxer, a puncher, and watch the landscape. But nah, you got to use your true identity. Just like Sean Porter went into the fight with Ugas. He wanted to be a boxer. You look at that Sean Porter versus the Sean Porter we know, two different fighters, two different mentalities. You got to go in the fight with Joshua and leave everything on the table. You see me? So if y'all seen that fight with Parker, I'm here to tell you, CBT Casual Boxing Tour, he's not that fighter. He's a different fighter. He's a beast. You see me? He's a warrior. And look, man, this is the biggest life-changing money he ever seen, and he's getting it early. So I think that he's going to go out and do everything he can do to defeat Joshua. Tall order, but somebody got to try, right? Because the other guys don't want that work. So at the end of the day, you rocking with your boy CBT, man. I just want to let y'all know, man, y'all see the LDBC going down, man. We shutting these dudes' channels down, man. We shutting these dudes' mouths down. That's more important. You know, forget the I didn't even mean to say shutting down channels, because I want these dudes to exist. We need these guys to exist. I just, for me, my beef with them is all about, you know, countering their garbage. You know, as far as my boy Anthony Joshua being, you know, not winning the fights. That's what I want to shut down. You know, the fact that they believe that Deontay Wilder is the truth. That's what I want to shut down. So we already shut down the fact that your boy, King Kong, ducked Joshua. I heard a lot of guys from the LDBC admit that. Now we got to figure out why they're not going to say the same thing about Deontay Wilder, because maybe they didn't get the videos. But I'm going to put the link in the description. But Shelly Finkel said Deontay Wilder won't be free until 2021. So there's no need to talk about the Joshua fight. That's not a guy that's confident. That's not a guy that want to be the best. That's not a guy that says you're one face, one name. You see what I'm saying? So he already know that he's going to fight a bunch of bums. Like I told y'all before in my last video, man. They trying to set up the Luis Ortiz, I'm getting confused. Ortiz versus Joshua Sloppy Wilder pay-per-view. And that's the fight they're going to push to the public. They're going to say, well, you know, because, you know, Ortiz gave Wilder a great fight. He almost knocked him out. And Wilder prevailed, came back, and knocked him out cold. You know, that's going to be the theme. That's going to be the storyline. But at the end of the day, man, we not falling for it. And I already cut my showtime. I already let it be known. I am not paying for not one pay-per-view, man. That's done. So you can try to hype the fans all you want to. We already seen it. We don't want to see it anymore, man. We want to see Joshua versus Ortiz or Joshua versus Sloppy Wilder. And they going to get the understanding when the fans don't support. You see? Because when the fans don't support his next fight, they're going to say, nah, we can't do this. We can't do no more bum bashes. We got to get this paper and we got to make the fight. Yo, Sloppy Wilder, you got to get in the ring with the best, man. It's about time, man. Come on. I let your boy, you rocking with the best. CBT Casual Boxing Talk. It's all about boxing, man. What you need to do is rock with your boy and let this beat ride out. Subscribe to the channel, man. Hit the notifications. That's the button up top, man, because you rocking with the best, man. Rock with your boy. Peace. It's gonna be a tough one, people. Weigh in coming soon. Stay tuned. You rocking with the best channel on YouTube.